bit of support, whatever you can help. So Rotary, they have their beautiful blue and yellow shirts on there, or blue aprons, and they'll just move throughout you. And the foundation here in Tamworth, you should go up and visit the Hall of Fame up there with all the memorabilia. They collect our Australian country music history, the memorabilia of all our country music artists, and they record it and preserve it and have a great display. They've got a new display up there, so it's well worth a visit. So please be generous, and thank you very much to the Rotary. Ah, now we have a favourite. All our bush balladeers are favourites, but we have one coming out now. He has a fantastic following no matter where he goes. He has a great following right throughout the country, and I'm sure you will have seen him at many festivals. He travels a great deal, don't you, Tom?
Certainly do, Di. Certainly do.
Tom Maxwell, everybody.
Righto, here we go. Ho, 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 yeah. It's a long straight road and the engine is deep. I can't help thinking of a good night's sleep. And the long, long roads of my life are a cold and vague. These rough old hands are glued to the wheel. My heart's full of sand from the way they feel. And the lights coming over the hill. It's a long, tough pull from way down south. Man's gotta find a little bread for his mouth and a home for a girl as sweet as my honey can be. So it's down through the gears, she's just starting to pull. The gauge on the tanks are showing me full, and the lights coming over the hill are blinding me. Yeah, there's rain on the road.
Thank you, Tom. Fantastic as always. Thank you. Our next artist, she is a fantastic yodeler. And she actually hails from Queensland. And I think a little while ago she did win a world championship yodeling competition. But today she actually won the female vocal for the Gold Medallion Awards at Queensland. Would you please welcome Laura Downing? Hi, Laura. Fantastic. Congratulations on the award.
Yeah, it was a bit of a shock.
Oh, no, not at all. You have a new album.
I do have a new album out called The Guardian, as a matter of fact.
And I believe that's the song you're going to do for us tonight.
It is.
Thank you, Laura Downing.
Thank you. Hello, folks. I think, well, you reckon we're going to get this rain? You reckon?
We pushed our luck 100 times from Alice back to Burke, and I thought there'd be 100 runs to go. But tonight the truck felt different. I could feel the load was shifting. Just what it was, I really didn't know. I shrugged it off and blamed it on and shuddered through my soul. It was right then that I realized our luck had just run out, and I knew this one was bound to take its toll. There was nothing I could do but watch the highway disappear, the offside shoulder rising to my face. Then the sounds of metal screaming, smashing glass, I must be dreaming. Then deafening sounds of silence in its place. I'm a little shiny dog that sits upon the bonnet mute, who sees it first and proudly takes the lead. And I'll tell a different story for each run that's been before me, 'cause I'm a little dog who's from a different breed. See the twisted wreck come into view, with half the wheel still turning and the smell of diesel burning. To watch in shock was all that I could do. By the time that help had found us, well, the wheels no longer turn, and the smell of burning diesel left the air as they cut us from the wreckage. In their face I clearly see the sort of should have to be. They took me off the bonnet and they placed me on his grave to watch over him while still taking the lead. And although I cannot see him, he'd be up there driving still, 'cause men like him are from a different breed.
Thank you, Laura Downing. We will see you around town for sure. Well, I think, what do you think of this band, our Back to the Bush band? Fantastic. Fantastic. Top band. We have Rodko here. Rodko on bass. We have Mike Kieran. He was on fiddle, now guitar. Doug Gallagher on drums. Stewie French over here on lead guitar, Michelle Rose on steel, and Amos Morris. I give them a wonderful big hand. Top class band, I tell you. Well, we've got a young lady coming out now to sing a song for you. She's making quite a name for herself. She's going to do a great job. She always does. And she's doing a song that My cousin wrote, actually, so I'm really pleased about that. Would you please welcome Alice Benfer?
Okay, good afternoon everyone. This is my first time on the Back to the Bush show. I'm really excited to be here tonight. This song was written by Anne Kirkpatrick. It's all about travelling around the country, going from town to town, singing those good old country songs. And it's titled The Showman's Daughter.
So you'll do great.
Ready to go. She's traveling no more. you very much, and thank you to the band.
Thank you so much, Ella. That was beautiful. A nice choice of songs. And this is the type of future that we hold in our traditional and ballad music. Thank you so much. Before you go, are you working anywhere tomorrow or... You are. Well, just tell people quickly where you're working.
I've got two shows tomorrow. One's a TSA at the Square Man Inn and the other one's with Melissa Robertson and friends at the West Hamworth Bolo. So I'm in the official guide, so just take a look and thank you for listening. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Alison. Yeah, please come along and support all our artists if you see them around, because we all need support. Now, the next young fellow that's on this show, his name is Greg Bain. Come out here, Greg. A very hard-working balladeer. He gets right around the country, supports many other ballads. He plays bass, he's got his own sound system, and he's just an all-round good worker, a wonderful fellow to have with us. Well, and you're going to sing...
Yeah, Pete, I'm going to sing a bit of a tribute to Brian Young and Buddy Weston. I'm going to do the old Thistles on the Hillside, mate.
What a wonderful song. Greg Bain, ladies and gentlemen, big hand. Thank you, Greg.
Oh, thanks, folks. Well, I've lived here in this country for 30 years or so. I've travelled through the outback and beyond. I've done my share of droving and mustering in the north, and I've even swam the Mitchell full in flood. Oh, I'm proud to be Australian, I've left no doubt of that, and if need be for this country I would fight. But a few beers after sundown, when I'm sitting all alone, it's when my childhood creeps into my sight. And there's thistles on the hillside, the heather's full in bloom, the North Sea breaks a half a world away. The sheep are gently feeding on the lush grass of the glen, and I fancy I can see myself at play. Mother's softly singing the lights of Aberdeen, as shadows sway to flickering candlelights. Ah, the colours of Australia can't wake me from my dreams. Heart is back in Scotland here tonight. Full in bloom, the North Sea breaks a half a world away. The sheep are gently feeding on the lush grass of the glen, and I fancy I can see myself at play. My mother's softly singing the lights of Aberdeen, as shadows sway to flickering candlelights. Ah, the colours of Australia can't wake me from my dreams. My heart is back in Scotland here tonight. Ah, the colours of Australia can't wake me from my dreams. My heart is back in Scotland here tonight. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you, Greg. And Greg, before you go, where are you working tomorrow? Or
tomorrow I'm out at the Oasis Hotel, and then I'm at the Balladeers Homestead for a lunchtime show there. Then I'm over it for the third super concert at LBS. So if you can make it along, great shows, all of them. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Greg Bain, ladies and gentlemen.
Great job, as always, Greg. Well, Pete and I draw straws, and I said I get to introduce the next artist, or artists, I should say. We're very pleased to welcome some family to come out and sing. We have a very big country music family, as you probably know, and they all love country music and sing country music. And of course, we all consider you part of our family, an extended family. We all love country music. Well, I'd really like to welcome out our next artist, please. Would you please welcome Anne Kirkpatrick, my cousin Anne, she's coming out, and her daughter, Katie Arneman. So you're in for a treat.
Thanks, Di. Thank you. Lovely to be here again. And we'd like to do a song that I recorded with Tracy Costa. And it was actually the first song that my dad, Slim, recorded of Stan's. so it was quite fitting that we recorded it. And it's really special for me that my daughter Kate is here for this Tamworth Festival. And we're going to do it with the song Back to the Saltbush Plains. Thanks, fellas.
Heading for the Saltbush Plains, way out toward the setting sun. I rest as hard as been tied down by a boy and by a town. Now I'm gonna throw the slip rails wide. Why could we want to shout? Let my wild emotions out as I break a fire from this high. I wanna let my voice go free, reckless gallop through the trees. Scrubber's tail. Hear the timber round me break. Feel the saddle leathers quake as I down a scrubber by the tail. Duck or snuff, hear the dingoes have a monopoly. Hear a thousand kettles snip as I rush from there and I can't pull that noise and music down to me. I'm throwing up these city clothes, going where the kitchen grows, heading for a western cattle run. Leave my sweet on a catch train, heading for the Saltbush Plains, way out toward setting sun, a way up towards the setting sun, a way up towards the setting sun. Hi, dee-la-lay, hey, go, dee-la-lay, hey, go, dee-la-lay, dee, hi, la-lay, dee.
Thank you so much. Great to have you here, girls, and great to see you, Katie.
Di, it is so great to be back.
Where are we going to see you this week?
Well, for all those early birds, 9 a.m. tomorrow morning, would you believe, a hell of an early show.
That's
right. At the Balladeers Homestead. So Kate will be there and my brother David, and we're looking forward to it.
Oh, great. Well, thank you so much.
Thanks
we'll see
lot.
You.
See you, everyone.
And we'll drop in tomorrow, too. And don't forget, folks, the Rotary West Tamworth are going around collecting donations for the Country Music Foundation. Well, it's my pleasure. It's such an exciting time. This is fantastic. I hope you're enjoying the concert, are you? Yes. Well, there's plenty more Balladeers to come yet. But it's my pleasure now to introduce a fella who's come along to quite a few of our Back to the Bush concerts here. He really does need no introduction. He's a fantastic fella. He loves our bush ballad music, and he's come along again to sing another song for you, and he really doesn't need any introduction, so please put your hands together for Troy Cassidaly. Thank you, Troy.
Thank you very much. Holy jingoes. I didn't know whether we'd get blown away here before. What was going on with that weather? When I arrived, I thought, I'm lucky to keep my hairs in place. What's going on with that? Now, a song that I've loved to do for many, many years, a really, really old one called Leave Him in the Long Yard. It's one of those things that you can't really get through many gigs without playing if you're going to sit on an acoustic guitar. Would you agree? So if you know any of the words, please feel free to sing along. It's a beautiful old song. I think we're going to do it in the key of E. Do you want to do a turnaround, Stewie?
Well, he's looking kind of jaded, and his sight is not the best, and the hair around his muzzle's turning gray. He has seen 100 musters And I think it's only fair that we leave him in the long yard here today. He was broken in the 60s, maybe 63 or 4. Never faltered, always seemed to be on hand. Never have I seen him beaten by a bullock in the bush. And at night watch he was pick of all the land. To leave him out there in the long yard, do not rush him. Leave him out there with his mate, the Baldy Blade. Leave him there to love to smoke, oh, and we'll catch him. We'll pull his tail and turn him out today. Well, he's looking kind of jaded, and his sight is not the best, and the hair around his muzzle's turning gray. He has seen 100 musters, and I think it's only fair that we leave him in the long yard here today. He's entitled to some kindness in return for all he's been. Now he's failing and his step is getting slow. Let him squander his last summers by the river with his mate, in a paddock where the sweetest grasses grow. Sing along if you know it. Leave him out there in the long yard, do not rush him. Leave him out there with his mate, the Baldy Bay. With his mate where he can graze and he can laze with. Leave him there and we will turn him out today.
Now the chorus.
Leave him out there in the long yard, do not rush him. Leave him out there with his mates, the Baldy Bay. Leave him there to love to smoke, oh, and we'll catch him. We'll pull his tail and turn him out today. Oh, yes, we're there and we will turn him out today.
Turn us around, fellas. Thank you very much, folks. Thank you for coming to this beautiful town of Tamworth. And thank you to Don and Peter.
Thank you so much, Troy.
What a gentleman. Troy comes along and supports us. And he's just one of those fellas you can't say enough about. Thank you very much, Troy. Well, right now we have another fellow who works very hard in the industry. Come out here, Chainsaw. He was a bit worried about following Troy, but Troy told him not to worry because he's a gentleman. We're all in country music together. Chainsaw Lindsay, Ken Lindsay. He has his own radio program, works very hard for the industry. And what are you going to sing tonight for us, mate?
Going to do a song, a tribute to my late great mentor, the great Rick Aitchison. He's been gone 10 years this year, so I'd like to do one of Rico's songs called Home in Durham Bandy.
A great choice. Please make him welcome Mr. Ken Lindsay.
My old mate yesterday, was he going home, did he say? For his last home would drive to Durham Bandy. And was his old face kind of pale, like he'd spent some time in jail? Did he still have a scotch and soda handy. He's never been inside a cell, it's just that he don't feel so well. The jugheads and the twisters have taken their toll, and what he's been through and done, you see, is legend to blokes like me. And would you believe he's really not so old? But he gave a thrill to many a crowd, from old Isar to the sea. And he's covered grounds of black soil, red and sandy. And I wonder if you saw him, is there a word for me? Was he heading home for one last ride, home in Deer and Band? Faded jeans and faded shirts, hiding inside years of hurt. His nightly bed, just a bench on an old park lawn. All possessions down the years, parked for whiskey, wine and beers. And now it seems there's nothing left to pawn. His hair and beard with three parts grey, when we were drinking the other day. He was talking about years of falls and hooves and scars. And then a tear came to his eye, mumbled something about he'd soon die. When I left him in that crowded oasis bar. But he gave a thrill to many a crowd, from old Isar to the sea. And he's covered grounds of black soil, red and sandy. And I wonder if you saw him, is there a word for me? Was he heading home for one last ride, home in Deer and Band? Was he heading home for one last ride, home in Deer and Bandy?
Mr. Chainsaw Lindsay, good on you, mate. And listen, before you go, who's that fella up there backing you in the green shirt there?
Oh, that's me best mate, Lindsay Waddington, and he's actually up for a golden guitar, you know, this Saturday.
I was going to say that.
We've all got our fingers and toes crossed.
We certainly have. And let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, that is Lindsay Waddington over there from Crosscut Records, and you record with him, don't you?
Yep, great producer, great writer.
Well, because we can't fit everybody on these shows, Lindsay said, don't worry about me tonight, I'll just go and back Chainsaw. And let one of the younger blokes on. I think that's the sort of spirit we want to see. So how about a big hand for that alone? But also, as Chainsaw said, you're up for a gold guitar, mate. That's great stuff. So we want you to play that tonight, if you wouldn't mind. So please make a big hand, Lindsay Waddington, or Waddo, as he plays his instrumental he's up for, gold guitar for instrumental in the golden guitar. Thanks, mate.
Thanks for having me, Pete and Di. Thanks to the band.
Thank you. How is that? You can see why he's up for a gold guitar nomination. Thank you, Lindsay Waddington. Fantastic. Well, our next artist, he's already here. Part of the Gun Barrel Highwaymen. They travel around the country all through the year. He's going to sing a fantastic song for you. There's Terry Gordon, everybody. Terry. And Terry, where else can we see you during the festival?
Well, tomorrow we're with Reg and Owen down at the Diggers Club and around a few other places. Sunday.
Fantastic. Yes. Hard-working fellas.
And music festival, this is wonderful tonight. I hope all you people checked your pills, got your pills checked.
No. Terry Gordon.
Here's a song that was written by a gentleman that won the Song Maker of the Year. He's been an old mate of mine for many, many years, wrote a lot of songs for Slim, and he got the award last night. And it's a song I recorded about 20 years ago called The Champ. It was 110 in the water bag, and we were having a drink or two, talking about the fights we had and the blokes we'd seen and knew. At the end of the bar, drinking with the flies, was a bloke no one had met, about 5'2" in his high-heeled boots and 9 stone ringing wet. He'd fought Darcy, Patrick, Rose, Mundine, Famishin' and Sands, out on the grass, in the ring and in a dozen foreign lands. And he thought he could have beat them all, but he suffered constant pain from his back he heard ring back and out on the One Tree Plain. He said, I've knocked about a bit and I've fought in Sharman's tent, and he looked as if he might have too, by the way his nose was bent. I'm not a bloke disguised, he said, but I beat him twice my size. I can do it one hand kneeling while the sun shines in me eyes. Oh, he'd fought Darcy, Patrick, Rose, Mundy, Famishin' and Sands, out on the grass, in the ring, in a dozen foreign lands. And he thought he could have beat them all, but he suffered constant pain from his back he heard ring barking out on the One Tree Plain. Now in 52 in Old Moree by the muddy river glider, he went 10 rounds in an old jam tent with a big old redback spider. He fought a big goanna once, he thought he'd met his match. They fought all day in a camp oven, he came out without a scratch. He'd fought Darcy, Patrick, Rose, Mundy, Famishin' and Sands, out on the grass, in the ring, and in a dozen foreign lands. And he thought he could have beat them all, but he suffered constant pain from his back he heard ring barking out on the One Tree Plain. Yeah, he'd fought Darcy, Patrick, Rosa, Mundy, Famishin' and Sands, out on the grass, in the ring, and in a dozen foreign lands. And he thought he could have beat them all, but he suffered constant pain from his back he heard ring barking out on the One Tree Plain. From his back he heard ring barking out on the One Tree Plain.
Thank you, mate.
Mr. Terry Gordon, ladies and gentlemen. That worked.
Well, we're going to do a song for you now. This is one that we wrote about a fella who found gold fever, as a lot of people did in the gold rush days. And some made their fortune, some did not. But this is a tale about Paddy, and it's called Paddy's Soul.
Please. green eyes shone like the emeralds that came from his Irish descent. He was there to cash in a small bag of gold with most of it already spent. These were on the right side of Sydney, for the name of Patrick O'Shea, a well-to-do man in the making, young Patrick was well on his way. Then he heard of gold in Kyandra, and the story so often being told. He left all the things that he worked for the love and the glitter of gold. Patty's young wife found a new love, a man on the land so where it told. And Patty just borrowed more money till his assets and business were sold. He became a man only so for the glitter of gold. And in a dirt floor humping in Kyandra, young Patty grew bitter and just well mentioned. Oh, Patty has regained his soul.
Thank you so much.
Well, I think it's time here for Peter Simpson to do an instrumental for you. A good bush ballad instrumental. And what's your choice there, Pete?
Oh, thank you so much, Di. Well, there's so many great artists we've had here this afternoon. But look, I'd like to do an instrumental. I was born up in the Snowy Mountains area. And I think one of the greatest combinations of poetry and song was when Slim Dusty put that beautiful tune to The Man from Snowy River. This song means a lot to me, so I'm going to try to do a bit of that as an instrumental. Not the whole 7 minutes, though.
Thank you. thank you so much, and thanks to our wonderful band.
Thank you, Peter Simpson. And that is the acoustic style of the Bush Ballad guitar. Fantastic, Pete. Thank you. We're going to introduce one of our favourite artists as well. I'm just going to take this out. There we go. Alrighty, this fella hails from Queensland, from Brisbane. He has an album called There's Still a Country Boy in Me, and that is the truth. He'll always be a country boy. He's written some fantastic songs, Tibbergargan amongst one of them. Would you please welcome Johnny Greenwood?
Thank you, Diane, and it's wonderful to be here as usual, and we certainly enjoyed the show. And anyway, I'd like to kick off with a song that I have written quite a lot of songs, as Diane said, but this one is not my song this time. It's written by Mike O'Malley of South Australia. Mike passed on a little while back, but he's had a great deal of admiration for him. And this one's called My Old Australian Home. Now, I've read lots of stories of lands across the sea, of Paris in the springtime, and a home in Tennessee. But I have never longed for a distant sunny clime. Give me the peaceful pleasures of this dear homeland of mine. It's a land dear to me, where I always long to be, just an old Australian home, where the rabbits
Mr. Johnny Greenwood, a great mate of mine. He's been in the business a long time, and we're very privileged to have you here, John. Where are you working tomorrow? Anywhere?
Working here tomorrow, yes. We're doing a bit Slim Bazza and Stan, I think, tribute tomorrow, and so we've got a few shows through the week still, so and we'll catch you around the place, and it's always wonderful to catch people everywhere down here in Tamworth.
Well, it's wonderful to have you here, mate. Big hand for Mr. Johnny Greenwood. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have a very, very special guest with us this afternoon, a fellow who is his own person. He's unique. He's unique to Australia. He's unique to us. We think he's wonderful. So please make welcome the one and only Mr. Chad Morgan. Thank you, Chad. And when I say he's unique to Australia, he really is. And he's going to stop the storm for us as well. Have you enjoyed the night? Come on, have you enjoyed the night? Yeah. Righto, we'll have a really, really big round of applause once again for Mr. Chad Morgan. Thank you so much for being with us tonight, Chad. I shall leave you in his good hands.
Ah, oh, thank you. It was a little bit late. I couldn't find my peg leg out in the wet. Ah, oh, thank you very much for all that. Let's see if we can get some sound here. Okay, can you hear the guitar out there, or is it? Okay, we haven't got much time, so there's a story before I start this song, but I won't tell the story, we'll just get into the song, but I want you to help me out with this. I'm just going to sing the chorus. It just goes, he rides a motorbike, a shiny motorbike. When it comes to the shiny motorbike, I'll get you screaming out the top of your lungs, over the top of the rain. Shiny motorbike. You do that, okay? Okay, here we go. The Claxton boys were on the prowl at a local dance. This cute little Shirley kept looking at Win and he thought he had a chance. But then this handsome bloke turned up, said, let's go have a drink. And he and the Shirley left the floor before poor Win could wink. Win said, who's that flashy mongrel? As his heart dropped with a thud. Someone whispered breathlessly, it's the duck and Willis stud. He rides a motorbike. The girls all sigh as they were died, as live on in his blood. He rides a motorbike. He'll never be another like the duck and Willis stud. He's tallly wide and handsome, his hair wavy black. He comes from somewhere in the scrub and he lives in a stringy bark shack. All the Sheilas follow him no matter where he goes. Why he's like a human magnet, no one really knows. Why do the girls keep hanging round? Why do they cling so close? Whatever it was when they handed it out, he copped a double dose. He rides a motorbike. The girls all sigh as he rides by, there's loving in his blood. He rides a motorbike, a shiny motorbike. He'll never be another like the duck and Willis stud. He was shy and awkward when he was just a kid, but it didn't take him very long to learn what the big boy did. Well, back in 1949, he bought his motorbike, and riding back in the pillion seat, the girls all seemed to like. He used to jam the brakes on hard as they roared down the track. He loved the feel of the Sheila's boobs as they slammed into his back. He rides a motorbike, a shiny motorbike. The girls all sigh as he rides by, there's loving in his blood. He rides a motorbike. He'll never be another like the duck and Willis stud. Why, he's a fitness maniac, no one really knows. I think it's because he wants to fill every bit of his fancy clothes. One early morning on the beach, he'd just run 20Ks and had started exercising just after the break of day. He was halfway through his push-ups when a drunk said, oh, I don't know. Well, I think you're wasting your time, young fella. She went home hours ago. Oh, he rides a motorbike. He motorbike. The girls all sigh as he rides by. There's loving in his blood. He rides a motorbike. There'll never be another like the duck and Willis stud. Yeah. Oh, thank you. Anybody getting wet out there? Okay, I'll finish off with a little song that I always sing, especially for any of you girls out there that think I might be getting a bit too old. Anybody thinks I'm over the hill? Well, I've got news for you. This one's called As Life in the Old Dog Yet. All the Sheilas seem to think I've had me day, and my longing to make love has gone astray. Well, my head'll let you know I'm a red-hot Romeo, and I'm ready if that blonde there wants to play. Women think that when you're my age, you're all done, and you ain't got what it takes to fire a gun. Well, my passion's at its peak, I'm the chic of Scrubby Creek, always looking for the chance to have some fun. Yes, there's life in the old dog yet, there are still things I can do, so don't forget. And you give me half a chance, I might wind up in your pants. Cause there's life in the old dog head. Just the other day while going for a swim, I was standing near this redhead needing trim. When she smiled and said hello, my desire began to grow, and it made the situation rather grim. So I dialed into the water out of reach, just to cool my thoughts about this little peach. You can imagine my disgrace and the look upon her face as I pole vaulted from the water to the beach. Yes, there's life in the old dog yet. There are still things I can do, so don't forget. And if you want to let her rip, well, I've got a red hot tip that there's life in the old dog yet. While visiting the Warwick Rodeo, me missus said, come on, you have a go. So I rode this bucking nag till its gut began to sag. I won the prize and collected all the dough. Well, the missus really thought I was a toff, and she said to me the minute I got off, I didn't know you could buck and turn. Tell me, Chad, where did you learn? I said, you taught me when you had the whooping cough. Yes, there's life in the old dog yet. There are still things I can do, so don't forget. And if you're in any doubt, why not come and try me out? Cause there's life in the old dog yet. Thank you very much, and thank you for sitting in the rain.
Right. Chad, thank you so much for being with us. And a big applause, Chad Morgan, ladies and gentlemen. Now, I know it's raining out there, and I know it's raining fairly heavily out there, so we're going to do the best we can to carry on with the show at this stage of the game. So would you please, mate, welcome our next artist, Mr. Pat Brown Jr. Thank you, Pat. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for being with me. And Pat's got a new album coming out soon. When's that coming out, Pat?
That should be out within probably the next 2 weeks. Unfortunately, we're held up with a bit of technical difficulties.
Okay, go back, Pat. We're just moving a bit of gear back here for obvious reasons, but we won't give up. As we said, Pat's got a new album out, and it'll be out soon. He comes down from Coffs Harbour Way, and a great ballad here. A great singer, and he's really nice to have you here tonight. Once again, a big hand for Mr. Pat Brown Jr. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much. Now, as Peter was saying, I'm bringing out a new album. I'd like to do a song from that. This is a very pretty Joey McKean song, and I'd like to dedicate this to all the mothers out there tonight. There are many, many mothers in the future. There are many, many mothers gone before. Through the ages I can hear their sound of weeping as they watch their sons go marching off to war. Will there never be an end to all their sorrow? Will there never be an end to all their strife? Will there never be a world of peace in our time? Will there never be an end to taking life? To love and to forgive. I can see you now. But little can we do with all this hatred. How can we teach a whole world how to live? Every mother is the same the whole world over.
mother's whip could fill an ocean. As they send their sons to fight across the sea. Many mothers gone before. Through the ages I can hear their sound of weeping as they watch their sons go marching off to war. Oh yes, so many, many mothers gone before.
Pat Brown Jr. Pat Brown Jr., everybody, has a brand new album coming out very, very soon, or perhaps it might just be out, but look out for that one. And of course, we had Chad Morgan here, you know, one of our early pioneer country music artists. He's been here through the years. Well, we have a young couple coming on now, and I reckon they're going to be around for quite a long time and making a good name for themselves. We've seen them here at the festival the past couple of years, busking down there in Peel Street here and there, and they're on some shows this festival at the Abba Homestead and here and there. So would you please put your hands together to welcome to the stage here for the first time, Lockie and Georgia, while they sing Plains of Peppermint for you. Give them a big hand, everybody. Make them welcome. Some of our young up-and-coming artists.
Hello, Tamworth. Shame it's raining tonight, but that won't stop all the good music yet to come tonight. This is me and Lockie's first time here, and we're really excited and very grateful that Diane and Peter asked us to come up here. And for our song today, we are going to do one of our favourite Slim songs, The Plains of Peppermint. Thank you.
Georgia. What a great job. Do you like that? Yes. I think they have a big future coming up. Thanks. We enjoyed it so much. We'll see you soon. Thank you. And our next artist is keeping country music in the family, and that's what we love to see. He's come up all the way from Sydney, and we're so pleased to have him here again with us. And he travels the world quite a bit, and I'm pleased to introduce my cousin, David Kirkpatrick, everybody. Good job, huh?
Slightly shorter. Well, that's just fantastic, seeing Georgia and Lockie. I met them last year, actually, and went and watched them busk. And that would bring great joy to Slim and Joy, seeing their songs still being taken on by that sort of generation. And that was the whole thing about what they wanted, to share their music, get it around the country, and to inspire more people to keep singing about Australia. So good on them, and it was lovely to see them do that. So we've done a lot of Slim and Joy songs tonight, so of course I'm going to do another one. And this is one of Joy's that Dad did. It's called Ring It From the Top End. Well, I'm a ringer from the top end, where you gotta know your job and what you're doing each day. 2 million acres, you know you're gonna earn your pay. If you're gonna take it on, there's one thing that can't be forgotten. No one else does the job like a ringer from the top end. Out on the fence line, swallowing dust, blood in my hands from the bar. Open that rope, oh, don't see the soul before I get him in the yard. But I get a funny feeling in the middle of my back. Sure enough, he's coming like a train down the track. No one else moves much faster than a ringer from the top end. Hey. Take a kind of pride in saying I'm a ringer from the top end. Pull out my swag, get the bow I dream, then I'm out like a light. Thinking about those girls in town, next thing it's broad daylight. But there's no time for thinking what might have been. I'm in a dirty bull catcher with a muster routine. Gotta keep your mind on the job, you're a ringer from the top end. No one else does the job like a ringer from the top end.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very
Thank
much,
you all
David.
Thank you very much. Thank you for staying out in the rain. Hope it gets
We can
better
do better
you.
Than that. Big hand for David. Before you go, David, I believe that we might be able to catch up with you tomorrow morning somewhere.
That's right. At 9 o'clock at the ABBA Homestead. Anne will be doing her regular concert there, and I'll be there doing a few songs as well, along with a few other guest artists. So if anyone wants to come along, we'll see you there.
Thank you very much, David. And go along and support those wonderful family. We'll be there as well to sing a couple of songs and support, so please do that. Right, now we've got one of our band members to sing a song, a multi-gold guitar winner, a real talent as far as a musician and a singer and a songwriter. So please, mate, welcome to the stage a fellow that's helped us with this show nearly every year, works hard, Mr. Amos Morris. Thank you, Amos.
Thanks, Pete. Well, Greg did a Brian Young song earlier, and I think it's only fitting to do another one. This is a beautiful old tune called Walk Away, Let's Forget.
One, two, three.
let's forget it's too late. There's too much to lose, too much at stake. Too many words have been spoken, too many hearts will be broken. We had our chance long ago when we were free. Now the happiness of two homes depends on you and me. Walk on by, try not to cry, it's too late. Why should others have to pay for our mistakes? Too many words have been spoken, too many hearts would be broken. Learn not to want what's not ours to have, you see. Learn to live without the things that we know can never be. So walk away, let's forget, it's too late. There's too much to lose, too much at stake. Too many words have been spoken, too many hearts would be broken.
Amos Morris, everybody.
Thank you very much.
How about Amos? That's a Brian Young song, isn't it? What a beautiful song, and thank you. What a beautiful job you did of that. Just gorgeous. Thank you. Well, you know, part of bush ballads, you know, when you go to our festivals, bush ballad festivals all over the country, all the time. It's such a popular genre, the bush ballads. Bush poets are a big part of the festivals, and I'm sure you've seen many bush poets and a lot of bush poetry here at the Tamworth Country Music Festival. They make you sad, they make you laugh, they make you cry, they just tell some fantastic stories. And we've got a fella here now that we, come on out, we run into him at lots of festivals. This is Ray Essery, everyone, the Mullumbimby bloke. So he's going to do you one of his new ones, a new poem, and I don't know what it's called. Yeah, I'll let you tell everybody all about it.
Thanks, Diane. Isn't it lovely to be on this stage with all these Australian balladeers?
It's fantastic. And look at all the people here. Thank you so much. And say hello to the people at home.
Hello, Mullumbimby and Brunswick Heads, up where I come from, and the Richmond River, where I milk cows all my life. And it's just great to be. And I never thought
it
when
is.
I was milking
right
cows
here in Tamworth.
I'd be standing on a stage in Tamworth.
Here you are, and I'm looking forward to the new poem.
Okay, love.
Ray Essery.
Thank you. Isn't it amazing, have so many balladeer followers around Australia still? And when you hear the songs of those old balladeers, like Slim Dusty, your memory goes back to a place and another time, doesn't it? Like when I hear the rain tumbles down in July, then my mind goes back to when I was sitting in the dairy helping me mother and father milk cows with the old radio going on the wall. Isn't that amazing? And when I hear the songs like It Must Have Been a Hell of a Party or From the Gulf to Adelaide, I remember my old mate, old Tommy Oliver, who I travelled with, and he wrote 52 songs for Slim Dusty, did old Tommy. So I just put this little yarn together for you, eh? When the songs of old Slim Dusty start drifting through my mind, I'm rolling along a highway, leaving time behind. I've forsaken all my problems with a place and another time, with those songs of old Slim Dusty drifting through my mind. I was somewhere up in Queensland and the rain was falling down. I was sitting in a bar somewhere in a lazy outback town. The girls were oh so pretty and the girls were being kind, with the songs of old Slim Dusty drifting through my mind. I met a little girl who said her name was Jane, and we travelled all Australia by motor car and train. But when it was time to settle where the sun would shine, then those plains of Pepperdine started drifting through my mind. Yes, those plains of Pepperdine started drifting through my mind. Years have passed me by now, and well, I'm just a tired old man, as I sit beside an open fire in this old and ancient land. And when I see those heavens where the cross I'll find, then those songs of old Slim Dusty start drifting through my mind. And when I meet my maker out west of the Great Divide, or somewhere up in Queensland, or by the Lachlan side, I'll sit and tell those stories of a life I left behind, with those songs of old Slim Dusty still drifting through my mind. Thank you and have a great night.
Thank you very much, Ray. And where are you working tomorrow, mate? Where?
In tomorrow at the Long Yard. In the morning breakfast, I'll be there at the Long Yard.
You'll see that fellow there, one of our best poets. And now we have a real treat for you. We have a group of people, Peter Code and the Code Sisters, along with Jim Hermel. And Peter is the president of our Bush Ballad Association. They've all worked very hard and been very successful. So, Pete, would you like to tell them a couple of words while you're setting up, and I'll help you?
Well, hello, folks. It's great to be here. Thank you, Pete, Diane, for having us here. Yes, we represent the Balladeers Homestead up there and on Gunaganoo Road, Street 28 Gunaganoo Road, and well, Ballads there, three shows a day. But we also, the Balladeers Bulletin Magazine, and we're promoting the Bush Ballad, Australian country music. But it's so great to be here with all you folks today.
No one works harder in the business. They do a great job. They're very good friends of ours. So please make welcome Peter Code and the Code Sisters, along with our great brother up the back there, Mr. Jim Hermel.
And this song's a little gospel number I wrote back in the early 90s. One called, I think it probably fits the situation out there, but it's called Riding Out the Storm. It's on the TV news. See how our world's being torn. I hear them preach salvation, how to save God's creation. mother's little children are hoping that we can find a way of coping, for even they can see the danger that we're in. But the world keeps on fighting, and the flame there igniting, peace will reign when God rules as king. But in the meantime, we're riding out the storm. The Bible says the waiting won't be long, until we celebration when God rules all nations. In the meantime, we're riding out the storm. And now I'd like to hand you over to the Code Sisters, Virginia and Lynette. What have you got for us there?
Well, we're going to do a song that's from our new Code Sisters album, which is coming out in February, and it's one that Lynette wrote, and I put some music and a bit of a yodel in, and we call it the Flinders Rangers Yodel because we originally come from South Australia. So we thought it'd be a good idea to write something about our local area, and the Flinders Rangers are a big part of that. So here we go. My heart
Music, Peter Code, the Code Sisters, and Jim Hermel up here on drums. Thank you, Jim. Peter, before you go, can we just have a little chat for a moment? Peter here is the president of the Australian Bush Balladeer Association. They do a great job in promoting bush ballads, producing a quarterly beautiful magazine, I might say. It's well worth joining, isn't it, Peter? Sorry? It's well worth joining.
Oh, my golly, yes. It costs $25, $25 for four of the quarterly magazines, and keeps you up to date with what's happening in the bush ballad world, the traditional country music world, the country music clubs, with all the new product, venues, the festivals right around Australia. So if you want to pop over to the homestead there on Gunaganoo Road, the Salvation Army complex, you can join up. I said $25 and you're in touch with what's happening in the traditional world out there.
That's exactly right. It's a great read. I reckon every artist that's on the show tonight will have a little story in there. But the Balladeer's Homestead, down there at Gunaganoo Road, great shows every day.
Every day from the Friday the 18th right through to Friday the 25th. Three shows a day, two main shows and a member showcase in the evening. So it's a chockers block. We have fantastic crowds out there. And also the Salvation Army provide all the food. So there's plenty of good tucker out there. And there's plenty of parking. Just drive in, plenty of parking. So it's a very comfortable place.
It's a great venue. And you will see many, many bush balladeer artists down there.
Almost everyone.
Thank
almost
you.
Everyone, including almost Diane and Peter and everyone else.
You'll see us there too. Thank you so much, Peter.
Thank you, Diane.
Well, our next artist coming along, he loves country music and he's going to tell you, country music's all he plays. Please welcome Owen Blundell.
Thank you very much, Di. Well, this is a song that I wrote a few years back, and this is my 40th year in country music. Just grab a bit more guitar there, guys. Just something like this. You can clap your hands and stomp your feet to the music I will play. If you know the songs, you can sing along. Back and forwards, you can sway. If you don't like country, you can go. If you like it, you can stay. Hey, hey, 'cause we're gonna have some fun tonight. Country music's all I play. I'll sing you songs of love gone wrong, if it takes your fancy. Of the mountain tie with a stockman ride, with the legs of old and bandy. Of the outback towns and the bush around, and the tales of yesterday. Hey, hey, I'll make you laugh, I'll make you cry. Country music all I play. You can clap your hands and stomp your feet to the music I will play. If you know the songs, you can sing along. Back and forwards, you can sway. If you don't like country, you can go. If you like it, you can stay. Hey, hey, 'cause we're gonna have some fun tonight. Country music's all I play. Well, before TV, the family and me would listen to the radio. And we'd all tune in on a Sunday night to a country music show. With old Buddy and Tex and Slim and Hank and Johnny, they would say, hey, hey, we all love the music, country music's all I play. You can clap your hands and stomp your feet to the music I will play. If you know the songs, you can sing along. Back and forwards, you can sway. If you don't like country, you can go. If you like it, you can stay. Hey, hey, 'cause we're gonna have some fun tonight. Country music's all I play. Yes, we're gonna have some fun tonight. Country music's all I play. Hey, hey, hey. Thank you very much. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to feature a song now from the father of Australian country music and New Zealand country music. He started country music in Australia back in the 1930s and New Zealand. And I'm going to do a little impersonation of old Tex Morton. For those that have never heard Tex, he passed away in the early 80s, but here's my Tex Morton impersonation for you, for those that have never heard Tex. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tex Morton. I was born in 1913 and passed away in 1983. When I was a little boy, my mum and dad used to have a little yellow cat. And they hated this cat, tried to get rid of it any way they could. Then someone wrote a song about it, called The Cat Came Back. Now old Mr. Johnson had worries of his own, had an old yellow cat that wouldn't leave home. Tried everything you knew to do to keep the cat away. Took him up to Canada and told him for to stay. But the cat came back the very next day. Yes, the cat came back. Don't know how he did it, but the cat came back. He wouldn't stay away. Now this cat was a terror, so they thought it was the best to give him to a fella who was going out west. The train ran around the curb and hit a broken rail. Not a blessed soul aboard the train lived to tell the tale. But the cat came back the very next day. Yes, the cat came back. Don't know how he did it, but the cat came back. He wouldn't stay away. So they threw him in the kennel while the dog was asleep, and the bones of cats lay piled in a heap. Well, the kennel burst open and the duck flew out the side with his ears chewed off and holes in his hide. But the cat came back the very next day. Yes, the cat came back. Don't know how he did it, but the cat came back. He wouldn't stay away. I hope no one is eating at this present time, because this is a very gruesome verse. So they snuck into the shop while the butcher wasn't round and put him in the hopper where the meat was ground. The old cat disappeared with a blood-curdling shriek, and the town's minced meat tasted furry for a week. But the cat came back the very next day. Yes, the cat came back. Don't know how he did it, but the cat came back. He wouldn't stay away. Well, the farmer on the corner said he'd shoot the cat on sight, loaded up his gun with nails and dynamite. Waited in the garden till the cat came around. 7 little pieces of the man was all they found. But the cat came back the very next day. Yes, the cat came back. Don't know how he did it, but the cat came back. He wouldn't stay away. So they put him in a rocket ship heading for the stars. Got a message back saying landed up on Mars. Said the men were doing fine and the monkey and the rat, but they couldn't find a trace of the old yellow cat. But the cat showed up the very next day. Yes, the cat came back. Don't know how he did it, but the cat came back. He wouldn't stay away. No, he wouldn't stay away. Thanks, everybody. Have a great festival.
Owen Blundell, everybody. That was a Tex Morton song, wasn't it?
Yes.
It was fantastic, and he does it so well. And of course, Tex Morton's one of our early country music pioneers. Well, we'd like to thank the Tamworth Regional Council for supporting the Back to the Bush concert and the sponsors for the Tamworth Country Music Festival. So, and all of you for being here and at home, of course. You know, I'd like to say a big hello to a special lady at home, Heather McKean. That's my mum. She's watching tonight, so hi, Mum. We're all sending our love and best wishes. Well, while our next artists come along here, there's so many bush ballad shows around Tamworth, country music shows and artists. So I know you will have been all out and around and seeing so many shows. I'm going to introduce a lady now I'm sure you all know very well. Here at Tamworth, they're from Tamworth, and this lady has written so many songs, and they have a new place there called Musicland, and we'll talk about that a little bit later, and LBS Studios. But I know this lady just recently, as last night, TSA Awards. There is a gospel song. They won that. She won that with Jean Darnell. And a gold medallion award. Yes, so thank you. So please welcome Shazza Lee.
Thank you so much, Di. Lovely to be here. Always great to be in the park for this massive concert. And here's a song I wrote about my family's homeland. It's just called Land of Our Kin. I still see the old folks sitting on the front veranda, looking out across the land of our kin. Granddad cleared that land by hand, and Grandma worked beside her man aside all the time they lived. I remember
Hello.
Hello. Thank you so much, Shazza. Could you... It's so wonderful to have you on the show.
Thank you so much.
I wanted to ask you about Music Land.
Yes. Could you tell us? Music Land is a little 27-acre property that Lindsay and I have just outside Tamworth.
Just a little space.
Yes, about 7 minutes south we are from the studio on Gunaganu Road. And we've actually just put a stage in there and we have a camping facility. And it's a little bit of a project, it's a long-term plan, but we're hoping that it builds into something really good for traditional country music into the future, Di.
Oh, that sounds fantastic. That's what we need to, a little bit of space and a lot of country music.
Absolutely. Thanks so much.
Hi, Pete. Right,
a big hand for Shazza. Well, right now, it's my real privilege to introduce this gentleman to you. He needs no introduction, as we always say. His name is Lindsay Butler. He's a legend of guitar, he's a legend as far as record producing goes, and he's a great fellow. He's just done about everything you can do in Australian country music, including things like Roll of Renown, OAM for his service to country music, and he's certainly a great mate of mine and someone that I admire as a guitar player and a gentleman. So please, mate, welcome Lindsay Butler, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much, Peter. And it's always a great pleasure for us to be in this concert. It's a big one in Tamworth for real Australian country music. And for me, it's wonderful to get to play with these blokes back here. Old Rod Coe, old Doug Gallagher, old Fett over there as well, and old Michelle Rose, as well as old me. And I'd like to introduce to you, with this instrumental, a young bloke that's just started playing bush ballad guitar. And his name is Anthony Baxter. So give Anthony a big welcome here, eh? Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Thank you.
Mr. Lindsay Butler and Anthony Baxter, just wonderful. As we say, Pete would have said, Lindsay is certainly a master of the bush ballad guitar, and young Anthony Baxter there, he's certainly on his way. So thank you so much. Our next artist now coming up, he records at the Lindsay Butler Studios. This is Ashley Cook, everybody.
G'day, everyone. How are you going?
Ashley has had some really... he's had a really fantastic and exciting Tamworth, haven't you?
Yes, we have, Di. Yeah, we were lucky enough to pick up a Brumby Award on Thursday night for a male bush ballad.
I was there. I saw that.
Yep,
it was
right.
Good.
So it was good. And a big surprise on Saturday, Hands of Fame.
The Hands of Fame. So this coming Saturday after the parade, make sure you get down to the park there for the Hands of Fame where Ashley is being inducted. So congratulations on that. You're in with very good company there.
Yes, I'm very proud.
You've well deserved. You've been a hard worker for the Bush Ballads. And a new album?
Yeah, new album out. It's going to be released tomorrow out at LBS.
Tomorrow?
Yes,
oh, fantastic. Right. That is great. And I know you've got some shows coming up. What about the one on Saturday? I know I've got to be there.
Friday.
I'll be there.
You better be there Friday, yeah.
I will be there.
4 o'clock out at Musicland. It's Aussie Heroes show we're having out there. So it's a tribute to all the Aussie pioneers, I suppose.
Yeah, good one. And I'll sing a McKean Sisters song.
Good on you, mate.
Okie doke. Ashley Cook.
Thank you, Di. This is a single off a new album. And it's a song written by Rick Gay called The Murrinjay. Just drove a touchy mob of stores across the Murrinjay, and the trouble that they cause can make you wonder why. You don't call it a day, give the droving game away. Once this life gets in your blood, it's in your blood to stay. Now take a break and rest here for a little while, and I'll find another mop and make another mile. You know beggars can't be choosers, but I swear to God I'll cry if I have to drove again the Murrinjay. If I have to drove again the Murrinjay. Nothing worse than taking on a touchy mob, but I learned long ago it's all part of the job. You just know it won't be easy no matter how you try, especially if that touchy mob's out on the Murrinjay. Of all the tracks I've driven, she's by far the worst. If you don't die from some fever, you'll die of thirst. It doesn't really matter if the season's wet or dry, there's always danger on the Murrinjay. Yes, there's always danger on the Murrinjay.
Here we go.
If the ghosts of all the drovers who have died along that track could convey a message to you to tell you to turn back, all the cattle will start rushing in the blinking of an eye. Never turn them in the Lancewood out on the Murrinjay. With good reason, someone christened her the track from hell. Some 20 drovers never made it through to tell, and the old bloke still agreed. She's an awful place to be. With the troubles that I've had, you'll get no arguments from me. When Buchanan opened up the track, he never knew the pain and suffering she put those who followed through. And I hope a lot of years go by, and better still that I never have to drove again the Murrinjay. Never have to drove again the Murrinjay.
Thank you.
very much. Thank you.
Ashley Cook. Before you go, Ashley, the Murrinjay track, it's part of our Australian history. That's right up in the Northern Territory, isn't it?
That's right. It runs from Top Springs up in the Territory down to the Barkly Tablelands. It's only about 250 k's long, but it's one of the toughest stock routes in Australia.
Yeah, a lot of people perished on that track. Yeah. And they would have taken a lot of cattle across there too. Part of our history. Great
That's
song.
Right. Thanks, Di.
Thank you, Ashley. Oh, welcome, Peter Simpson.
Thank you, Ashley. Ashley Cook, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, right now I'd like to introduce you to a really lovely lady of country music. Lynette Guest. Come out here, Lynette. She's been on the circuit for many, many years. She's still as beautiful as ever. She has a lovely voice. She has a wonderful personality and a wonderful attitude towards country music. It's always a pleasure to have you here, Lynette.
Thanks very much, Pete, for those kind words.
So what about a really big applause for Lynette Guest, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much. It's really a pleasure to be here. And I'd like to do a yodeling song for you called The Queensland Yodeler.
Everybody. I just love having Lynette on the show. Some of the early Gold Guitar Awards, you were on those, weren't you, singing? You did a lot of backing?
Did a lot of backup vocals with a couple of other girls, and for about 10, 11 years we did
that. Wonderful. You do have a great voice, and thank you. We love having you here.
Thanks, Di. Nice to be here. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you so much, Lynette. Well, we're just having a little bit of a band change over here. While we're doing that, I think I should reintroduce the Back to the Bush Spectacular, the band. all the fellas here, led by Rodko on bass. And, step forward, Rod. Rodko. Mike Kieran on fiddle. We'll go around this way. Doug Gallagher on drums. We have Amos Morris here. Michelle Rose. Michelle Rose on steel. And Stewie French. Now, Little Bird has told us that Stewie French is leaving Australia for a little while. And although we're quite sad at losing such a fantastic musician, I call it record producer, but a studio CD, just so much, a fantastic musician, we wish you well. He's going to America, to Nashville, taking the family over there for a while. He's just going to show them what Australians can do. We need you over here.
French has been with the Back to the Bush band since we started. He's a great support and has helped us make this as success as it is. And he's a wonderful guitar player, but not only a guitar player, he has recorded a lot of our balladeers, and it really has helped to our standard of recording of our balladeers. We'll miss him, and we want him to remember us.
We do. We know he's going to be a great ambassador for Australia, and we hope you hurry home, but we know you're going to enjoy it over there while you're there. So we wish the family all very well, and we want you to remember us.
The only problem is with Stewie, he hasn't got a hat.
You don't have a hat.
But he's got to wear one tonight because
no,
we...
No.
Not he doesn't have to do that.
One. Not
on behalf of Diane, myself and the Bush Ballad team, we'd like to present you with a brand new Akubra Snowy Mountain hat.
To take with you.
You can look just like me now. But please take it, wear it, mate, and we do mean everything we say. Thank you very much for your time you've been here. And we wish you every success in the States, mate. Thank you.
We do. And
thank you, guys.
And you know what? The first time you're on the Grand Ole Opry, you better wear the hat.
And send us a picture back.
I better, hadn't I? I'll definitely wear it, especially an Akubra. Gee, it's even the right size. How do you know?
Whoa, I know. Doesn't he look good?
Well, just made it just a little
bit
big.
Hey, Camille, he looks
good. Just a little bit bigger, so when he gets over there and gets a big head, it'll still fit him. Thanks, Stu.
Thank you.
Thank you. Sorry?
What do you got next? And talking about hats and country music, this next fellow is the real deal. He's a good friend of ours. He's up for a gold guitar this year again for Bush Ballads. Please make welcome Mr. Dean Perrott. Go on, yeah, Dino. Yeah. Just before you started, tell the people what you're up for, mate, the guitar, and tell them what you're going to do tonight. Thank you, Dean.
Yeah, g'day, Pete. Yeah, g'day, folks. Yeah, no, it's... once again, we've got the privilege of being in the finals of the Bush Ballad Gold Guitar, so there's some great competition in there this time, I tell you what.
Well, good luck, mate. We want all our balladeers to be successful, and you certainly have in the past. Well done. Big hand for Mr. Dean Perrott.
Thank you very much, folks. You got those territory eyes, a heart as big as Queensland, and a dusty smile. Outback woman, you come right my way. A rugged beauty like the Kimberleys, your soul is here to stay. There's a road train roaring across the border tonight. You got the Kenworth thundering on down the Barkley line. Triple trailers are swaying, the load beneath her control. Peering out in the high beam, she lets the big wheels roll. Outback woman, you got those territory eyes, a heart as big as Queensland. Here to stay, picking out blacks. sword in the oxbow, she swings up to her throne. Then her angler perfection is to the saddle below. Just the tail of the wieners riding out green colt. She's at home on a stark horse, that's the world that she knows. Outback woman, you got those territory eyes, a heart as big as Queensland and a dusty smile. Outback woman, you come riding my way, a rugged beauty like the Kimberley, the soul is here to stay. She's a wife and a mother with love so gentle and kind, with the pride in her family that never leaves her mind. Always walking beside them through the thick of the thin. Australian woman, her spirit within. Here we go now. Outback woman, you got those territory eyes, a heart as big as Queensland. A rugged beauty like the Kimberleys, your soul is here to stay.
Ah, thank you so much, Dean Parent. All about Outback Woman. Couldn't do without them, that's for sure. Thank you, Dean. Please welcome Lorraine Fitzner to the stage. Lorraine is such a hard worker here in Tamworth. Uh-huh. One moment, here we go. There we go. Lorraine has a lot to do with the Hall of Fame here in Tamworth. And the Bronze Bus. Have you been down to see the Bronze Bus, the new Frank Ifield? If you haven't, go down there to the parade and have a little look. So what's happening at the Hall of Fame right now?
Well, there's a lot of new displays. If you came last year and saw them, there's a lot of new ones down there. There's the one dedicated to Rick and Thil Kerry, which has got a couple of people on there who toured with Rick and Thil, including the late Brian Young. There was a Troy Cassidy display down there, Elise Simmons down there. I could go on and on, but you got to go down and see it for yourself and not listen to me to tell you what's there. That's the main thing.
And mentioning Elise Simmons, the Hands of Fame. Elise will be inducted to the Hands of Fame Saturday.
Yes. That happens on Saturday morning at 10:30. A couple of people you've seen here tonight, Lindsay Wannington and Ashley Cook's going in. We start at 10:30 sharp to put them all in the cement forever. And you're in there, Diane.
I am indeed, and we'll be there. Pete and I will be there to watch the hands, new hands go in.
That'd be lovely, yeah.
So thank you. Lorraine Fitzner, everyone.
Thank you very much.
You took me with surprise when I looked into your eyes. You're the nicest thing a girl could ever find. I think of you all day in the most delightful way. So take your shoes off when you're walking through my mind. Take your shoes off when you're walking through my mind. Don't you know that what you're doing is unkind? Don't hurt me like you do. Just let me come to you and take your shoes off when you're walking through my mind. I hope someday you'll be standing close to me. We'll be together till the end of time. I'll be good. It's a million things to do. So take your shoes off when you're walking through my mind. Take your shoes off when you're walking through my mind. Don't you know that what you're doing is unkind? Don't hurt me like you do. Just let me come to you and take your shoes off when you're walking through my mind.
take your shoes off when you're walking through my mind. Thank you. Back to Diane and Peter.
Thank you so much, Lorraine. And I know that song was written by Jeff Williams.
Jeff Williams, he's a Queenslander fiddle player who got around in the 70s and 80s. He actually worked a little bit with the late Charlie Bellott.
Oh, lovely. Thank you so much, Lorraine. Keep up the great work. You're right. Thank you. Well, we have a family coming on now, as country music has families in them. Keith Jamieson is on his way out now. They travel around Australia, and I'm sure you'll have seen them. They travel around, do a lot of touring. Keith Jamieson. Alicia Smith's going to be playing on lead guitar. And young Caitlin Jane's going to be doing some harmonies with her dad. So, Keith Jamieson, everybody.
Good evening, folks. How are you? Did you get wet? Well, I'll tell you what's better than the heat, isn't it? I'll just plug this guitar in. Hey, what a great festival, isn't it? Great. It was going really well until the rain came, but they need the rain. What about Stewie's hat? Okay, folks, I'm going to have a go at a song that I wrote about the late Shorty Granger. And I did have most of the song written, and then Shorty passed away before I finished it. But I called it Mr. Winter Winds, and Caitlin's going to do a little bit of harmony for me, and then she's going to do a song after. He wrote the song called Winter Winds and Where the Willy Willy Spins, song of his Red River Valley Road, his sugar loaf mountain home, old Nuller where he used to roam, Port Macquarie where the Hastings flowed. And I'm glad to say I met the man, and proud to say I shook his hand, met his lovely wife called Ruby Jane. So I'll amble down the road of song, may I won't. Kempsey Town, all his life he stayed around, singing those good old country songs. He wrote about the life he lived, and he had so much more to give, a dinky dye, Australian proud and strong. And I'm glad to say I met the man, and glad to say I shook his hand, met his lovely wife called Ruby Jane. So I'll amble down the road of song, afraid I won't ramble on. St. Peter opened up the gate and said, come in and wrestle me, put that old guitar down by your side, and listen to the songs they sing, you will hear your ballads ring. Songs you wrote through life were full of pride. And I'm glad to say I met the man, I'm proud to say I shook his hand, met his lovely wife called Ruby Jane. So I'll amble down the road of song, wait, I won't ramble on, I know we'll meet on Shorty once again. Yes, I know we'll meet on Shorty once again. G'day there, little Billy Brown.
and little Rodney Walker. Rightio, folks. Put your hands together for Alicia Smith, the guitar picking chicken.
For all the Barry Thornton fans, and this has got to be one of my favourites that Barry wrote, and I think he wrote this back in around about 1968-69 when he was living down near the Tambo River down in Johnsonville, in Victoria. It's called Tambo River Blues.
Band. Yeah, they're unbelievable.
Wonderful, Alicia. The guitar picking chicken. Well, as I said, they're a family that do a lot of touring, a lot of travelling and recording.
Diane.
And of course, we're going to welcome the youngest member of the family, please, back on stage, Caitlin Jane Jamison, who's going to sing you a Johnny Ashcroft number.
Yep.
And it's called?
Little Boy Lost.
Caitlin Jane Jamison.
Wild new England ranges came the word one fateful day.
prays to God in heaven for her little boy lost. No one walks upon the street that they call the wild bush country, with thousand naked feet. They searched every hidden valley, but his trail they never crossed, and their hopes were slowly fading for this little boy lost. Yes, their hopes were slowly fading. Blazing sun beat down upon the earth that final day. With heavy hearts they prayed to God to show the way. Then from a scrubby gully came a voice they ne'er forgot. Where's my daddy? Where's my daddy? Cried the little boy lost. Where's my daddy? Where's my daddy? Cried the little boy lost. In the wild New England ranges, there's a boy that's known so well. There's a story that the townsfolk push but often tell. How we fought the wild bush country that men had seldom crossed, and a mother's prayers were answered for a little boy lost. Thank you.
Thanks very much, folks. Give the band, Caitlin and the band, another great round of applause. Good on you, Rod and Pat.
Thank you very much to Keith Jamison, Alicia Smith, Peter, and Caitlin and Jane.
Thanks very much, mate. Hope you enjoy the rest of the festival, folks.
And Jamo, thank you all for doing for country music, mate. And you had a great night last night. Good on you, mate.
We had a great night with the Legends Show. We've got another great night tomorrow night with the Travelling Family Country Show with Jeff Brown, Lenny Brown and the Brown Boys, and Alicia, myself and Caitlin. And also Robbie Walters up at the Southside Uniting Church, and then a big Bush Ballad Spectacular Day on Saturday, Australia Day.
Good on you, mate.
Good on you. Thanks, Pete.
Thank you very much. Big hand for Keith Jamison, Lucy Smith and Caitlin Jane. Speaking of Jeff Brown, I'd like to invite you out to the stage there, Brownie. This next fun fella, he's had a lot of success in the business, a genuine singer, a genuine fellow, always one of our favourite sons. Up for a gold guitar again, I believe, Jeff. Up for a gold guitar. You might be like to tell the people a bit about it, what it is. These little short fellas, mate, it's a bit of a worry, isn't it?
Yeah, Pete, it's a song called After January Rains. Pretty appropriate for the little episode here tonight, but it's actually a poem that was written by old Kelly Dixon, and actually on the brand new album there's about four there penned by Kelly that put tunes to, and I really like this one. It's I think it's probably one of the best written ballads I've seen for a while, actually.
I'm sure it'll be good. I haven't heard it yet on the record. I've heard the song, but we're looking forward to it. Good luck on the Saturday night, mate, and thank you for supporting this show, and thank you for being such a great bloke in the bush ballad scene. Thanks, mate. All the best.
My pleasure.
Jeff Brown.
Well, I've been down that Diamantina underneath that western sky, when the plains were decked in mirrors and the water holes were dry, when the bleaching bones of cattle lay like tombstones in the sun, and the dust storms blew relentless on the big Moncara run. Well, I've seen the sandhill flowers full of color all ablaze, and I sweated in a saddle and the bush folk know they're gifted with the grandness of the rivers and the sand hills and the plains. And we bear the pain of marching and the dreary desolation, 'cause we feel the price is worth it of the January rains. Yeah, we feel the price is worth it of the January rain.
Thanks very much.
Thank you, Jeff. Thank you, Lynn. After January rains, fantastic. Another family that take to the road and tour, Jeff, Lynn, and the three brown bombers, their three little boys. Please welcome to the stage a fellow who he hails from the Snowy Mountains area, right up in the cold area. And we've visited the sheep station that Ernie runs down there, and you know, I noticed quite a few bits of machinery lying around.
That's correct, yes.
Yep, bits of machinery down along the road. There's a long drive in, bits there and bits out in the paddock, Ernie.
They cost a bloody fortune and now they're all lying there broken,
they're
rusty.
Lying there broken. Okay, well, you should tell us about it. Ernie Constance.
Thanks, folks.
If it ain't broke, then it ain't been touched by man. I've spent my lifetime in the bush just battling to get by. And to keep up with technology, I tell you, mate, I'll try. I'd buy all the latest gear, but the young bloke is disgusted. By the time he gets to take his turn, the old man's got it busted. Scattered out across the flat. I never try and fix them up, just leave them where they're at. I'm not too good at fixing stuff with tools made, I'm all thumbs. One day I'll knuckle down to it, but one day never comes. Looks like a junkyard, mate, if you didn't cry and laugh. There's bent and broken, twisted gear and a plow that's pulled in half. There's mowers, rakes and balers and a shiny big class header. I used it once to strip a crop, now you won't find nothing better. Row on row in silence, them rusting relics stand. All driven to extinction by my two expert hands. There's tractors and there's four-wheel drives battered up and looking rugged. And most of them's been there so long they're well and truly buggered. Like a bull charging navigator, bust everything I touch. I never get mechanics in because they cost too much. Fixing stuff, but all to no avail. We'll tidy up this place one day when we hold it clear and sale. Yeah, just sell it all where it is, I reckon. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. That's how the saying goes. Well, they've nicknamed me the breaker, with good reason, I suppose. A young bloke, he works with me, a handy sort of lad. He says, if it ain't broke, then it ain't been touched by dad. He says, if it ain't broke, then it ain't been touched by dad. That's me, you know.
Mr. Ernie Constant, not only a great singer, but an absolute legend, bush ballad writer, and a great friend as well for many years.
Thanks, Pete.
And where are you working tomorrow, mate? Before you go, quickly.
I'll go down to Oasis for a while, and then we come back to the Slim Stand.
At a Balladeer's Homestead.
Tribute at the Homestead, yeah. And then we've still got a few more bits to do over the weekend.
So catch up with Ernie if you can, because it's well worth it. Once again, a big hand for Ernie Constance. You have some fans out there, Ernie. I reckon Stewie's playing better with that hat on. What do you reckon, Dougie? Okay, please make welcome now Mr. John Smith, another great, authentic singer. Some beautiful albums, a real good following too. When John sings, people listen, and he's a storyteller. Great to have you with us here. Big hand for John Smith.
Thank you very much, Peter. How are you all going tonight? Good of you to stay here through the rain. They say that I never could touch the strings with a touch that is firm and true. They say I know nothing of women and men in the fields where love's roses grow. I must write, they say, with a halting pen. Do you think that I do not know? My love burst came like an English spring, in the days when our hair was brown. The hem of her skirt was a sacred thing, her hair was an angel's crown. The shock when another man touched her arm, where the dancers sat in a row. The hope, the despair and the false alarm. Do you think the arbor lights on the western farms, you remember the question put. While you held her warm in your quivering arms and you trembled from head to foot. The electric shock from her fingertips and the murmuring answer look. The soft shy yielding of warm red lips. Do you think when I was a world away, and the sad old garden its secret keeps, for nobody knows today. She left a message for me to read, where the wild, wide oceans flow. Do you know how the heart of a man can bleed? Do you think that I do not know? I stood by the grave where the dead girl lies, when the sunlit scenes were fair. Neath white clouds high in the autumn skies, I answered the message there. But the haunting words of the dead to me shall go wherever I go. She lives in the marriage that might have been. Do you think that I do? She lives in the marriage that might have been. Do you think that I do not know?
Big thank you, Mr. John Smith. Thank you. You might as well stay up there somewhere, mate. Somewhere.
John Smith, everybody. Well, we've come to the end, almost to the end, of the Back to the Bush Spectacular. We really hope you've enjoyed the concert tonight. This is our fifth year and going well. I'm Diane Lindsay.
I'm Peter Simpson. And look, it's been a real pleasure to be able to put this Back to the Bush concert on. And thank you so much to all our other artists that should come over and volunteer their time. They could be out making millions of dollars, but they're here supporting this show.
Please.
So I want you all to come up.
We'll welcome all the artists tonight back onto the stage. They're going to join us in a finale song.
You're going to come up.
And while you've got your hands together, please keep a big applause for the Back to the Bush Spectacular Band.
And Amos Morris is going to lead us off in a minute with a great song.
So thank you. We'd like to thank everyone who has supported our concert tonight, the Tamworth Regional Council. Thank you all for coming along. The sponsors, just everybody. And you know, we hope to see you somewhere soon down the track. Somewhere during the year, or maybe right here next year at the Tamworth Country Music Festival. Perhaps right back here in Toyota Park. I think they're all coming along now.
Sorry about the rain. But once again, thanks to the Tamworth Regional Council for making this possible. And thank you for such a wonderful support, even in the rain. We do appreciate it.
We do indeed. Everyone on now? I reckon so. Well, Amos, we're going to do a version of Waltzing Matilda, so why don't you join in too?
Once a jolly swagman came by a billabong under the shade of a coolibah tree. And he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boy, "You'll come waltzing Matilda with me together." Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boy, "You'll come waltzing Matilda with me."
Turn around.
Down came the squatter, mounted on his thoroughbred. Down rode the troopers, one, two, three. "Where's the jolly jumbuck you've got in your trooper bag? You'll come waltzing Matilda with me.
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda. You'll come waltzing Matilda with me.
The jumbuck you've got in your trooper bag.
You'll come waltzing Matilda with me."
Up jumped the swagman, swam into the billabong. "You'll never take me alive," said he, "and his ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You'll come waltzing Matilda with me."
Everybody!
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come waltzing Matilda with me.
He sang and he watched and waited till his pretty boy,
"You'll come waltzing Matilda with me."
One more.
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come waltzing Matilda with me.
And his ghost may be heard as he passed by the little barn.
"You'll come waltzing Matilda with me. You'll come waltzing Matilda with me."
Good night, stay safe, and God bless you. Come back next year. Back to the bush, keep those bellas rolling, and have a good rest of the festival. Good night.
Thank you, everyone. See you again.